A very good morning to all of you and a wholehearted welcome to everybody in the room and also via our online channel. As we announced that, this is a hybrid conference, so we are happy that a lot of other colleagues, yes, of course, are here in this room at the University of Pécs, but joining us online from various different corners of the globe. So welcome, everybody. My name is István Tarrósy, and I am a physical scientist at the University of Pécs, also leading the Africa Research Center and one of the organizers of the 8th Pécs African Studies Conference, which we are going to open in a couple of seconds. We are organizing this conference in collaboration with a lot of important partners of ours from the United States, from Europe, and also from the African continent. We are going to focus on a very intriguing, overarching theme, and you can find that already in the title of the conference, Afro-Asian Relations in the Post-COVID Era. But there will be other, obviously, other African studies-related panels throughout the 2 days of this conference. First and foremost, I would like to welcome all our participants, the speakers, the chairs who accepted our invitation. We are so grateful for that. And also, we are so happy to welcome ambassadors and representatives of diplomatic missions accredited to Hungary. And I would like to now ask the rector of the University of Pécs, Professor Attila, to give a couple of opening remarks and to open the conference.
Well, welcome everybody, excellencies, organizers, participants, and I would like to thank for the organizers for their work. This is, my understanding, is the 8th International Conference on Africa, and I really do hope that this is going to be a success. The University of Pécs is actually involved in an internationalization project, and this is, I feel, really working well at the student level. Right now we have altogether approximately 22,000 students, and out of these 22,000 students we have approximately 4,500 foreign students coming from all over the world. And this regards actually the Hungarian state started some 5 years ago, if I am right, the so-called Stipendium Hungaricum program, which means that the Hungarian state supports the studies of students mostly coming from the East and from the South, so from Africa as well. And an ever increasing number of students are studying with the goal that after repatriating to their countries, unfortunately from certain regions, there are not many who want to go back to their mother countries, but this is just a remark, and I really do hope that an ever-increasing number will go back and actually be a useful partner of the Hungarian universities, of the Hungarian states, wherever they are going to be working in the future. And I also very grateful, I forgot to mention it, but I think Stephen mentioned it, that this conference is not organized only by the University of Pécs, but also by our African and American partners. Well, I think sharing experiences and sharing knowledge is very important. There is nothing new in it. We don't have to reinvent the wheel. Some of our colleagues have met the problems we are facing now and either find a solution or can give you or us some sort of advice how to solve it and sometimes how not to solve it or solve them. So I really wish you a very fruitful conversation, discussions, and I really do think that everything is given for a successful conference. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Miseta. We are going to have another talk, a speech by an important professor of African studies, African economics, who will be joining us online, Professor Judit, who is the president of the Africa subcommittee of the Hungarian Academy of Sciences, and a very important layer, dimension of all the efforts of the community of Africanists in Hungary to get better connected with the domains and segments of the Academy of Sciences as well. So it's important that we have that collaboration. So I would like to ask now Judit Kish to join us in and hear her talk. The floor is yours, Judit. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Because I can't see myself and I can't hear myself.
We can hear you, we can see you.
Okay, it's your fortune. So it's won't be really actually an opening speech. It just will be an opening note. So ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, dear friends, it's my honor and pleasure to welcome all of you on behalf of the African Committee of the Hungarian Academy of Sciences. And we have a long-lasting and very fruitful and friendship relationship with the University of Pécs, the Africa Research Center, which is the flagship of the Hungarian African Studies, and personally with István Tarrósy, who is the driver and the energetic motor of this flagship. The African Subcommittee is an umbrella organization for Hungarian Africanists. We are conducting research and we are teaching African studies in Hungary and in many other countries, including African countries. One of our aims is to promote international cooperation and mutual understanding, because I think that it is more important these days than ever. Our task is to disseminate our research findings via different conferences like the recent one. So I will be very brief, and I would like to wish you a very successful conference. Good luck.
Judit, thank you so much for these nice words. Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, Professor Miseta also mentioned, and I also underscored it a couple of times, that this conference is organized in collaboration with a lot of important partner institutions. The topic was chosen with care in the China-Africa Working Group at the University of Florida, Center for African Studies, who is represented here by the coordinator, actually, of this China-Africa Working Group, Dr. Agnes Leslie, a great partner. So please, Agnes, come to the floor and also say a couple of opening remarks.
Thank you, István. Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Your Excellencies, distinguished guests and colleagues and partners for being here this morning. We are so delighted that you're able to join us here in person or online. My name is Agnes Leslie. I'm the Outreach Director for the Center for African Studies. And as our partner here, Professor Tarrósy said, I also coordinate the China-Africa Working Group. It is such a pleasure to finally be at the University of Pécs. I would like to add my welcome to you all to this conference and to just the discussions that we're going to have. We've been working with Professor Tarrósy for some years now. We've been planning this for some years now. At first, when we talked about it, it just seemed like a mirage. We could see the sparkle, but it seemed like an illusion. But here we are. I'm so excited to be here. Thank you, Professor Tarrósy. Thank you, University of Pécs. Thank you for all our partners for making this a reality. I would like to welcome all conference participants on behalf of the Center for African Studies and the China-Africa Working Group, but also on behalf of the University of Florida, which actually hosts and funds our working group. The group has been very active in promoting academic discussions and publications on China-Africa relations. We have so far published 3 peer-reviewed academic journals, which you can actually access online via our African Studies Quarterly. The members of the working group that I should actually mention here include Professor Oscar Otele here, who's come all the way from the University of Nairobi and is part of our working group. It also includes some of our members who are joining us online, Professor Anita Spring, Dr. Lina Ben Abdallah, who is also joining us online. I would like to just add, you know, I'm just so excited that we're here, and I look forward to the deliberations that we're going to have. This is an extremely interesting topic that we're having right now, and we're looking forward to your deliberations. And as we would say in Swahili, Karibuni, welcome everybody. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Agnes, and for the great collaboration as well. When we mentioned collaboration, number of partnerships we should underscore, and yet another important U.S. partner, the strategic partner, is with us here today, Metropolitan State University Denver, the strategic American partner of the University of Pécs, represented by a nice delegation led by Dr. Tobani. Also, we have our partners from Poland, Jagiellonian University, the Africa Research Center at Jagiellonian University in Krakow, but also from Italy, Università degli Studi di Cagliari. And with Cagliari, we are forming a university alliance, which is a pretty new project in the European Union. These are the European University Alliances, and the name of our alliance is the EDUC, the European Digital University, together with Cagliari. But we also have other partners, such as the University in Pilsen, West Bohemia University in the Czech Republic or Czechia, as well as in South Africa, the University of Stellenbosch. Plus, we have the Hungarian Academy of Sciences, as you heard, and also a very important NGDO, a humanitarian organization, the Charity Service of the Order of Malta, but others also joining us online. So welcome and thank you so much for your collaboration. This is the eighth in a series since 2010 of African Studies Conferences in Pécs. And we are so proud of a gradual and very consistent kind of build-up of Pécs becoming one of the meeting points of African studies, actually in the macro region. We also added some other efforts to strengthen kind of a visibility in terms of African studies. And one of that is our journal. We have been publishing the Hungarian Journal of African Studies since, 2006-07, so actually 16 years now, as well as a lot of courses developed in the meantime. And amongst the future plans, you can find a joint master's program in African studies together with our partners. We are starting a work on that within our European Alliance network. When we put together this program, we couldn't forget about an important thing, and that is a sad thing, but a very important commemorative thing. When in 2010 we launched the Pécs African Studies Conference Series, we invited a lot of scholars, of course, all across the globe. Some came from the University of Florida, one of the mentors, the first mentors of ours, Professor Goran Hayden, and then yet another important mentor from Scotland, Professor Ian Taylor. We, because of a very sad event, he passed away, recently, I would say, still, we said to ourselves that we have to have him all the time with us. And of course we know, because we are into African studies, that if a person remembers the one who just passed out of basically the physical reality, the physical world we have, but a person still remembering the other person, that person will be with us, that person will be remembered. So we would like to dedicate our remembrance to Professor Ian Taylor. That's the reason why we launched an Ian Taylor Memorial Lecture. I would like to say a couple of words about Ian Taylor. He was born in 1969. He was a professor of international relations and African political economy in the School of International Relations, University of St. Andrews, and chair professor in the School of International Studies, Renmin University of China in Beijing. He was also a professor extraordinary in political science at the University of Stellenbosch, South Africa, a visiting professor at the University of Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, and an honorary professor in the Institute of African Studies, Zhejiang Normal University, China. A heavily versed Africanist, focusing on Afro-Asian relations, African politics, African political economy, and China-Africa relations. And he was also serving as joint editor of the Journal of Modern African Studies. Ian visited 44 African countries, plus Reunion, and was well-traveled in Europe, Asia, and North America. And I can recall, because we had so many memories together, that once we had a chance to apply for a conference in Moscow, Russia, he was so excited about that. By that time, I had the chance to visit the country and that conference earlier a couple of times. So I was so happy to show him around, you know, in the vicinity. His work has been translated into Afrikaans, Arabic, Chinese, French, German, Greek, Hebrew, Hungarian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Portuguese, Russian, and Spanish. So we would like to dedicate this memorial lecture to his very important presence and ever so important presence in African studies. And without further ado, I would like to introduce our keynote speaker who will be delivering this year's Ian Taylor Memorial Lecture. Professor Parik Karmody is professor of geography at Trinity College, the University of Dublin. He's also a senior research associate at the University of Johannesburg. His PhD is from the University of Minnesota in the US, where after graduation, he taught at the University of Vermont. At Trinity College Dublin, he directs the Masters in Development Practice and CHARM EU, yet another important European University Alliance. His research centers on the political economy of globalization in Africa, and he is the author of many important books in the field and publishes regularly in journals such as European Journal of Development Research, Review of African Political Economy, Economic Geography, and World Development. He is on the boards of Political Geography, African Geographical Review, Journal of the Tanzanian Geographical Society, and GeoForum, heavily important journals in our fields, where he was formerly, in the last one, GeoForum Editor-in-Chief. He's currently Associate Editor of Transnational Corporation, and he is a Fellow of Trinity College and was elected to the Royal Irish Academy and the Royal Academy for Overseas Sciences in 2018. Please welcome Professor Parik Karmody, who will be delivering this year's Ian Taylor Memorial Lecture.